Wow, what's up everybody? Once again, it's BrandMan Sean, and I'm back with another video. This is the second time around testing Repost Exchange with a totally different artist, and it's important that y'all watch all of these videos that I'm doing so you don't have to make the same mistakes, because I make some mistakes and I have some learnings throughout the process. I'm going to put a link to anything Repost Exchange related in the description. But yeah, if you decide to actually use it, you might as well watch these videos so you use it right. This video will be with the artist by the name of Band Sama. It's by one of my homies, as opposed to the first video, if y'all saw it, with Hadassah and My Funny Valentine, her song, which is a really dope song. Go check it out. But I'll have all that again in the description below and in a link that you should use if you want to use Repost Exchange in the description below. But I found out some interesting stuff throughout this one. There was one part of it that's extremely disappointing, and it's worth you watching, so you get it. Check this out. All right, I'm back once again to test out Repost Exchange. I promised that I would test not just that initial track that I did with Hadassah, but another track, because honestly, if I'm gonna talk about this, I wanna get the best idea of what these results look like. Like, how quality are they? So what I decided to do was not just do the Hadassah track, which obviously we've been doing some work with Hadassah. She has a lot of stuff going on. So people might say at the end of the day, her SoundCloud isn't popping, but she does have stuff popping elsewhere. Maybe it's coming from there. Let's be dead sure. Even though I think it's pretty obvious from watching in that activity over a day's range when I only ran the campaign for a day, it seems to be in line. Here's one of my homies, right? Dude has not dropped music very often. 4 years ago, 2 years ago, two songs over a 4 year period, essentially. And then last month, he just dropped 2, 4, 6, 8. I don't even know what you want to call it, an album, mixtape, an EP, call it what you may. He just dropped 8 songs out of nowhere a month ago. But he hasn't been building followings or fan base. His music is dope, though. And these are old songs, by the way. So I'm going to advertise one of my favorite songs of his called Brenda. All right. We're going to run this through Repost Exchange. And once again, you see, he only has 90 followers. He's barely dropped any music. He has no music on any other platforms. This is just SoundCloud. And these are all the tracks he dropped in a 4 year period. I used to argue with him that he should drop music more, but it was kind of more of a side thing for him. So let's see. Start new campaign. We got one running with Hadassah already. I'm going to run one for Brenda. And I'm going to go ahead and use the rest of the credits. Because with Hadassah, I'm testing two different ways. And then for this one, Deep House. This is interesting. Connect FaceTime later. All right. I'm not quite sure which genres I should target with this song. I think I'm going to leave it on any genre. Usually I'm big on targeting. So to be clear, for those of you who don't know, when you say the track genre, this is the genre that you selected on SoundCloud to associate with that track. And if you're marketing within that, what they allow on Repost Exchange is when you set up your profile, you can choose the genres that you're interested in. So some people aren't necessarily interested in these other genres, maybe deep house. So this, by leaving on any genre, I'm actually marketing or sending the song out to people to listen to when they aren't necessarily into deep house, which can be risky. I'm gonna go ahead and try it anyway, because I don't know if deep house really is the title for this song. I don't know if that's exactly correct. So I'm gonna just leave it at any genre, even though I got very specific with Hadassah's track. The maximum number of followers, I'm gonna take that up to 50K again, like I did with the second Hadassah campaign. See what this does. And I mean, from there is just set it and forget it. So let's go ahead and start this campaign. See how it goes. This is very easy. Let's see what the results are. I will update you guys with another video.
And all right, so I finished the first test, right, with this song, and I'm not gonna lie, I'm a little disappointed. I'll walk through why and the reasons I think it ended to the results that it did. So first and foremost, why am I disappointed? Well, I really like this song. But when I compare the results from this song, I only got 11 comments ultimately. Let's see, 2, 4, 5. Actually, I think I got 9 comments ultimately on this one. All right. And I just ran the Hadassah campaign. For those of you who've seen me run the test with the Hadassah campaign and watch that video, the first campaign test I did with Hadassah, I used 500 credits. And the second one, I used another 500 credits. 1,000 collectively. I used 1,500 credits for this particular song. And not only did Hadassah get, I think, 13 more comments, she also got maybe 600 more plays collectively. This one has 356 plays. Hadassah got at least 600 more plays. I think she got over 1,000, maybe over, getting, and she might be approaching 2,000 at this point. So with that being said, I spent 50% more money on this particular song and got less comments, all right, and I got less views. What might that be attributed to? Well, a couple things. Some of it might even be my fault, so I'll talk about that. Thing number one might literally just be the fact that the song takes a minute to get started. So I'll play a quick second. Of course, these links will be in the description below so you can see the songs and things, but let me play the song a little bit. Actually, no, I don't even need to play the song. I'll just go check in the link. But let's see. You can see this thing starts 40 seconds in. That's when the words start. And we've talked about that, right? We've talked about that again and again on my channel. I think so many people should be aware. When you have those long intros, you put yourself at a disadvantage. So maybe that's a part of it, all right? But the beautiful thing I think that this shows, again, is this is real activity, right? These are real people listening. This isn't just, hey, we're going to throw some bots or anything at it. Yes, we're going to put it in front of people and even encourage and in some ways maybe even incentivize them to comment, but they still have to listen to it, and then their comments aren't necessarily going to be something that's dictated as having to be positive, right? So even if I look at the ultimate results, you will see that this song got rated at 8.3. I don't know how that rated system happens, right? Well, actually, no, that one didn't get an 8.3. This song got an 8 versus a 9 for Hadassah's song, right? So that shows also people didn't like it for whatever reason, and or at least didn't like it as much or have as good of an experience with it. Now, here's the other reason that this song might have performed the way it did. My fault. I actually did that first campaign. I don't know if you guys remember. Well, this, I'll put these in the same video probably. So you should remember that I said, I don't know exactly how much this whole deep house genre thing really matters. So I'm going to let it market to anybody. I want to test and see if that's a real thing. If I made that mistake. All right. So to do that, I'm going to go to his page. I'm going to do a second test, and I'll have a video about that for y'all to watch to get an idea of the results. I'm only going to do 500 credits. 520 because it's being difficult. It's making me hard. Making it hard. Making me hard. Pause. So the track genre, we're going to stick it to Deep House. And I can't recall that first time that I do any sort of filtering. Let me check right quick. All right, so I did just double check, and I did some editing over here as well. I actually now talking to some people with the company and things like that, I now am against putting this maximum number of followers necessarily to this extent, but I'm going to put it at 50k because that first run I did with this song, I did it 50k, so I want to make sure I get, you know, I don't change too many variables at once. I just want to see the effect of having the track genre only in terms of the custom marketing campaign rules. So we're going to do that. All right. And now we're going to run it. And I'll let you guys know how this one does as well. All right. So you'll see those results of this video pretty soon. I'm going to drop it once the, you know, the test ends and I'm able to record a video, and I'll make sure I put a link in the description below as well, right, for that next part of this video as soon as it drops, so anybody who's watching this later on, you could just do that versus looking for it. Other than that, again, if you use Repost Exchange, you might as well do it through that link in the description below, just so I can register it. And because as I show people these things time and time again and collect data, eventually that helps me get in a position where we can take the impact we have and show people in these companies that it's worth having content creators show how these platforms work. It's worth supporting people to be transparent on these platforms and collecting data on how many people actually use and move to different places like this helps us, right, be able to continue to move as a channel and operate and just drop these free videos and advice videos. Because hey man, that YouTube ads checking ain't really nothing at all. So but long term, we love to do this and give back to the community. So once again, that link will be in the description below to Repost Exchange. So far, I really do like what I see, but there are some things to learn. And I'm going to do a separate video explaining just the concept, period, of how Repost Exchange works from my understanding and the things that I do like about it. And, you know, any potential cons as well. So that's it for this video right here. As always, if you like this video, go ahead and hit that like button. If you like it, you might as well share it. And if you're not subscribed, you know what to do. Hit that subscribe button.
It's the network.